What's up, fellow vloggers? Welcome to the Thursday edition of the Daily Diet. Today I bring you into my kitchen to talk about some quick, easy, and healthy meal ideas to satisfy your palate. I'm going to share a little creation of my own with you guys that I like to call Garlic Ginger Chicken Stir Fry. It's super simple, delicious, and pretty darn healthy. So let's go ahead and get set up. First thing I'm going to do is kick the wok up to, I don't know, full, whatever. I'm not really a cook, so I try to be, but you know how that goes. Spray it down with just a tad of text message. This is like olive oil spray. It's really good, actually. It's better than using a bunch of oil. This kind of eliminates the excess that you really don't need anyways. But olive oil is not really bad for you. It's kind of, I guess, one of the good fats that you can have. So anyways, we'll start with that. Okay, now what I've done is I've taken a boneless, skinless chicken breast and sliced it into strips like you would stir fry or fajitas and marinated it overnight with about half a cup of low-sodium soy sauce, about half a teaspoon of ginger, and half a teaspoon of fresh minced garlic. Now, as I've said, that marinated overnight, and it's got a delicious smell. I love ginger. I don't know about you guys, but it's pretty tasty. Especially if you're craving Chinese food like me, this is a nice little substitution for the Chinese food that we can't have anymore. Really important, though, make sure you get the low-sodium soy sauce. One serving size of soy sauce has about 900 milligrams of sodium in it, which is quite a bit, so make sure you get the low sodium. Okay, got the wok heating up here. I'm going to go ahead and throw this in here. I'm going to switch angles so you guys can see what's going on. All right, we're all set with the new fancy angle. I'm going to go ahead and show you. This is the marinade I let set overnight. You don't have to let it set overnight. It just depends on how potent you want the flavor to be, and I like mine to be strong. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and just toss this in there. Spread it out nice and even. Go ahead and splash just a little bit of that marinade in there. Save a little bit for later when we throw in our broccoli. Now doesn't that look tasty? Oh yeah. This is probably the first cooking video I've ever made. I was not trained in the art of cuisine. I've kind of come up with it on my own, as a bachelor usually does. But, you know, what I cook, I like, so, you know, whatever. Alright, now while this is kind of simmering here, I'm going to turn the heat down just a little bit. Throw the top on there for just a second. Now, to make this meal especially quick and easy, I have purchased steam fresh, bird's eye steam fresh, steam in the bag broccoli. It's actually, I live off of this stuff. They make a million different kinds of vegetables and flavors and combos and stuff. It is delicious, super healthy, and you know, if you're trying to get your veggies in, you don't feel like steaming them. I do have a vegetable steamer, but this is so much easier, and they taste great. You know, if you live alone like I do, you can actually make two or three meals out of one of these bags. So I'm going to pop these in the microwave, and then we'll go from there. Those steam in about 7 minutes, so I'd really recommend throwing them in before you add the meat. But hey, we're all new to this here, so we'll figure it out as we go along. All right, getting back to the chicken now. Kind of turn it a little bit. Turn the heat back up on here. Probably turned it down too much. Anyways, find a place to put my wok lid. Now, chances are this chicken is going to be ready before the broccoli is. As I said, you really need to put the broccoli in first. But that's no big deal. We'll just turn it down a little bit when we get there. It's still got a little ways to go, though. But boy, that smells delicious. Your sauce is going to brown a little bit on the bottom of the wok. I wouldn't worry about that too much. I'm not going to worry about it too much. You guys might, but I don't really care. Whatever.
Another variation you could do other than the broccoli is that bird's eye steam in a bag also makes brown rice. Which you could serve this over brown rice or maybe with the rice and the broccoli. I'm just going to go ahead and do the broccoli though. No need to get crazy. I'll save that rice for another night. Ooh, that is looking good. It's kind of caramelizing a little bit. It's got a nice little glaze on it. All right, we'll throw the broccoli in here in just a second. We'll be ready to go. All right, it looks like our broccoli's done. Now I'm only going to throw in about half a bag. Ooh, careful, it's hot. Yeah, we'll throw in about half a bag of this broccoli. We'll save the other half for lunch tomorrow. Doesn't that look pretty? What a great color combo. Go ahead, and I'm just going to dump in the rest of my marinade here. Just to give it a little juicy juice. The great thing about this meal is from start to finish, it really only takes about 10 minutes once you've got your prep time out of the way for your marinade and all that stuff. You can do that before you go to bed. And then have a quick and easy meal. Now, if you wanted to make two servings, you could do two chicken breasts in a full bag. But I live alone, and if you're like me, if you have extras laying around, you might want to eat them all. So I try to only cook single servings, no leftovers, unless I'm planning a lunch the next day. But really, the broccoli's already cooked, so you really just got to stir it around, get a nice coating with that soy sauce on there, and you're pretty much good to go. Yum, I can't wait. I go ahead and turn that off, and then we're ready to plate this bad boy. Whoops. And there you have it, my dear friends. Conga's quick and easy garlic ginger stir fry with broccoli. Delicious. Let's give it a try. All right, it's time to dig in. Get a little piece of broccoli, a little piece of chicken, and here we go. Oh. That's delicious. Well, that's it for my video this Thursday. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. Give it a try. I'll go ahead and put a little rundown on the ingredients at the end of the video here, but yeah. And the great thing about this is, if you're used to eating grilled chicken and, well, my meal every night was grilled chicken and steamed vegetables. It started getting really old after a while. So I had to find a little twist, kind of kick it up a little bit. I'm still eating my full serving of veggies. Got my chicken, just a couple of spices and seasonings, and there you go. And the great thing about it is it tastes just like something you'd order up at the restaurant. So, hey, you know, do your own variations, season to taste. Hope you enjoyed it. You guys have a great day. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
Like the fellow once said, ain't that a kick in the head? Like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in a boat? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. If this is just the beginning.